Hey guys, so welcome to OBC Academy. This is Yoshush Ansar. Okay, let's start today's topic. Today's topic is global enterprises or multinational company. In the last video, we talked about role of public sector. In this video, we are talking about global enterprises or multinational company. Okay. Before that, make sure you subscribe. Not only subscribe, turn on the notification so that every time we post new videos, you get early. Okay, without further ado, let's start this video. First of all, starting with global enterprises. What do you mean by global enterprises? Again, we'll discuss in a normal way. Global means earth. So enterprises means company. What does mean this global enterprises? The enterprises which exist all over the world, that's called global enterprises. In the other word, multinational company. Okay, in theoretically, global enterprises are a large institutions or organization. It's spread all over the world. Their marketing activities will be all over the world. They not only sell goods and services in one country, their production of goods and services are spread all over the world. And not only that, they also provide a variety of products, services, in the business. It depends on the country as well sometimes. So overall, they do business in different nations. In a simple word, if a company is doing business more than one country or across a border of the country, that is called international business or global business, which company has multiple networks. In the other word, it acts as a branches which operate in other countries as well. That's a multinational company, and their network is spread all over the world in the name of branches of his company. And not only that, their strategies in the business are multiple. They have a good strategies, they have good financial resource and all. We'll discuss in the features. Okay, this is global enterprises. If you ask example, every big companies are global companies or multinational companies. Like example, Infosys, Wipro, Apple, Intel. There are a lot of examples are there. Okay, moving on to the next one, that is features. Like this, you can see in this image, they get huge amount of resource. That's the first point, huge financial resource. These kind of companies or organization get very large financial resource. They can raise funds from any source. It may be stocks, debentures, bonds, or even from public, because as they spread it across the world, they have built a trust level in the stock market. So investors are ready to spend money, or investors are ready to give money for these organizations or companies. So that's why it has a huge financial resource. Not only that, they also get a huge profit every year. So that can be also finances for next year in order to start new business or new product line. So that's how these companies operate. Moving on to the next one, that is foreign collaboration. Usually multinational organizations makes agreement between other countries regarding exchanging of technology or in order to take advantage of low cost human resources. And some companies take advantage of taxes slab of their countries. So usually they will collaborate due to the technology or availability of raw materials. They make an agreement between other countries. Their main intention is to transfer technologies. So by global organizations or MNCs, we get opportunity for foreign collaboration. Next feature is advanced technology. These kind of organizations have technical advantages in manufacturing process or in other services. They bring standard to the next level. So by giving chance to other countries, companies, they provide a high class standard technology to another country. So these are the features of MNCs. Moving on to the next one, that is product innovation. This kind of companies always try to get forward one step ahead by innovating things. Innovative things can be happen only through research and development. Every MNC company has its own R&D department, that is research and development department. They involve in producing new goods, new services, new ideas. So this kind of research and development will help MNC's company to produce an innovative product and bring innovative ideas to the market. And not only that, they also have a huge financial resource so that they can spend on research and development. Moving on to next one, that is marketing strategies. Global enterprises are very aggressive in the market. they boost their sales in very short terms because they use an up-to-date marketing database. They know how to come to market with a proper advertisement or proper execution of plans in the market. Marketing is not an issue for them because they have done research in that extent. They know well before entering the market. Sometimes already established market will help them to sell the goods. Like just like Apple launched a new product. The moment they start accepting booking, everybody will buy it because of their brand name. So moving on to next feature, expansion of marketing territories. This kind of business are not limited to one countries. They have no limitation regarding boundaries. They expand their market territories with affiliations or through the network of branches. With that, we are moving on to next one, that is centralized control. So this kind of organization have a headquarter in one country and they have branches in different countries. So the main administrative operation will be done in the centralized unit. For example, Apple headquarter is in US, so it will operate from US. Every administrative, every event which is going to happen, the decisions are made by there and its branches follows here. Okay, moving on to the next point, that is joint venture. Joint venture is a business organization. It is nothing but joining hands with other business. As simple as that. They get so many benefits from it. We'll discuss that. When two business are joined together for a common purpose or for the mutual benefit, it is called as joint venture. So joint venture has its own types. So these are the types. It's not that much important, but okay, we'll discuss a bit. Joint venture has major two divisions, that is equity based and contractual joint venture. Equity based further divided into three groups. That is company, LLP, limited liability partnership, and other one is partnership. In contractual joint venture, it is divided into other subgroup, that is operational agreement or strategic alliances. Okay, first of all, we'll go through contractual joint venture. What do you mean by that? We just came to know what is joint venture and what is contractual joint venture. Here in this kind of joint venture, there is no separate new creation of a business, entire business. Their intention is to collaborate for a particular project. They don't even share their ownership. They only commence their business collaboration due to some project or some particular event. That is called contractual joint venture. If we move on to equity-based joint venture, EJV, here joint venture done with an entirely separate business. Two or more parties here willing to join together to form an entire new business. That is called equity-based joint venture. Okay, now we are moving on to the benefits of joint venture. The first benefit is increased resource and capacity or greater resource and capacity. Whenever two or more business join together or combine together to form a new business or they're coming forward for a common intention, obviously they have two huge resources, two huge companies or two huge resources merging together to form a new business. So that's how it increases the resource, or it has, that's how you can get a greater resource for a business. Whenever you have a joining hand with your team, obviously two is more than one. Okay, with the help of the joint venture, you can quickly grow, you can quickly expand, you can quickly acquire the market. So it increases your all resources, it multiplies, that's it. Moving on to the next one, that is access or access to the advanced technology. When developed country merge with any Indian companies, so there the advanced technology will be merged together in this market also. That's how we can access to the new market. When foreign companies joined together to Indian company, obviously in Indian market also, we get this advanced technology. There are so many companies like that. Moving on to the next point, access to new market and distribution network. For example, when foreign companies create a joint venture with an Indian company, it creates a new market in India. So this how it can distribute a new product in India, or it can create a new distribution network in India. Moving on to the next one, access to technology. When you merge with joint venture with other companies, you obviously get advanced technology in production or in services. Like there are superior quality of production, which saves a lot of energy, a lot of time, which increase the speed sometime. So it's a benefit again to access a new technology. Moving on to the next one, that is innovation. When new companies or new business came together to form a new companies or new business, they obviously have an advantages in every aspect. So innovation is a key here. Some company may innovate some ideas in other country and they may introduce in our country. So that helps to take a lead with the new ideas and technologies. So it's another way of occupying market. Next benefits we get as joint venture, low cost of production. Some intelligent joint ventures or international business will invest in India. The main reason they do that is here, the cost of raw material, the cost of labor is very low. That's why they try to invest in India and take a work from Indian people or workers. Here we have technically qualified people which will work for low labor cost. And sometimes in India, they also get cheap cost raw material. So this will help to reduce the cost of the production. From that, they can lower the cost of production. Moving on to next advantages, established brand name. You get a safe hand or you get a safe ride with an established brand name. When some business is already establishing and acquiring you as their joint venture in other country, you obviously get a good name. Like for example, Suzuki made addition to joint venture with Maruti. Maruti was a good brand on that time. So Suzuki merged with the Maruti and create its brand name in India with already established brand name. They don't need to wait. They don't need to introduce a new market, because when you acquire a new business or when you join to the already established brand name business, you get that advantages. You don't need to start from zero. You have already place to start with. You get a lead there. Moving on to next one, that is public-private partnership. This is another new topic which introduced few years ago. Okay, what is this? We already know what is partnership. Then what is public-private partnership? When public organization and private organization involve in collaboration, that is called public-private organization. Like for example, government agencies or government companies joining together with the private sector companies in order to use finances or in order to improve their transportation network in the other countries. These kind of public-private partnership, PPP, will came to force. So these are the important things in chapter 3. Next topic is the chapter end. So this chapter ends here. And if you like this video, hit like, share with your friends. If you have any queries, feel free to comment below. See you in the next chapter. Until then, keep watching. Bye for the day.